Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over how to clean and transform data using Microsoft Power Query. So to give you a quick overview of what we hope to accomplish in this video is we are going to take our data right here in a crosstab format where we have each month's worth of sales going across the top, and we are going to convert this into a tabular format where we have the product, the month it was sold, and how much it's sold for. Because when your data is in this format, it's a lot easier to use pivot tables and other tools to analyze your data. Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that. So when using Power Query, I can either have my data on a different tab inside the same Excel spreadsheet, or I can import data from another Excel spreadsheet. So in this case, I have a file called Power Query in Excel.xlsx, and it has my data in it. So if I'm to start a new blank workbook, and I want to import my Excel data into a new spreadsheet, I can go up to Data, Get Data, and in this case, I'm going to use From File because I have an Excel spreadsheet, but you can also import data from a database such as SQL Server or Microsoft Access or from various other sources. So if I go to From File and go to From Excel Workbook, I'm going to navigate to the data that I just showed you. Double click on that, and I can see my list of tabs in the Excel spreadsheet that I just showed you. So in this case, I'm going to select Table 1 because that's where all my crosstab data is. And then I'm just going to click Load. And now I can see that my data has been updated into this new spreadsheet. And I just want to show you something. I have January sales of 100 here, but if I Alt-Tab back to my original data source and I change the sales to 120, and then I Alt-Tab back to the spreadsheet I was just working on, it still says 100 right here. But if I go to refresh, as long as I have saved the source file, my data will update here as well. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So now that we have our data, our next step is to transform this data from the crosstab format to the tabular format. So I'm going to left click on A1 and just hold my mouse button down and drag all the way down here to the end of my data set and let go. And then I'm going to go to the data tab and select right here from table range under the get and transform group right here. And this is going to bring up Power Query. Now I may want to format these numbers here as currency since they are sales numbers. So I'm going to click on the first column, hold down shift, and select the last column. And then I'm going to right click on one of the column headings and go to change type. And instead of this being a whole number, let's change it to currency. And I'm going to click replace current when this comes up. And I can see this has been changed to currency because of the dollar signs up here. Next, I'm going to click on the transform ribbon up here. And then I'm going to go to this option for unpivot columns. And you can see that my values have been now changed into January, February, March sales instead of each having their own column for sales. And then I'm going to click on the home ribbon and go to close and load with this down arrow right here. And I'm going to choose close and load 2. And I'm going to keep it as a table and I'm going to put existing worksheet. Click the up arrow and select sheet 1, A1. Click this arrow again and say okay. And now if I go to sheet 1, I can see I have that data set in tabular form now. And so if I want to do pivot tables or anything else off of this data set, I'm able to do that. I can also quickly sort through my data, say that I'm not interested in the electric scooter anymore. I can just start cleaning up my data here and then do some further analysis on that. So this is just a brief introduction to Power Query. Out on our blog, we have several examples of other ways you can use Power Query to analyze your data. I'm going to include the link to our blog on this topic below in the description on YouTube. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.